Has your mind ever wandered to a faraway land full of unusual beings, where nothing is quite as it seems? If you could step into that world and stay there for a little while, would you? There once was someone who did just that. One moment she was here, and the next she was there. Who was that? I'm sure you're all asking. Well, she was a girl called Alice. It all began on a hot summer's day. Alice was sitting in the garden, too hot to move, but bored of doing nothing. She was contemplating making a daisy chain, when all of a sudden, something caught her eye. A strange creature was scurrying past. She stood up, her curiosity taking over from her common sense, as she decided to follow it wherever it went.
Let her down a rabbit hole, but where she would land.
Eating the cake turned out to be a mistake, as Alice began to grow and grow, and she didn't stop until her head touched the ceiling. Frustrated at her situation, she began to cry and cry and cry. Through bleary eyes, she looked down at her hands and saw that they were shrinking. "Oh, what's happening to me now?" she sighed, continuing to cry. All of a sudden, she found herself floating in a pool of her tears. "Which way should I go? This way, that way?" Alice murmured to herself, looking down each hallway. She settled on a direction and swam to the shore. She stepped onto the dry land and into a glorious garden and discovered that she was once again minuscule. Despite being mildly annoyed about her ever-changing height, she decided to explore, hoping to stumble across someone who could give her some advice. Alice stood, confused, for a minute or two, not quite sure what she should do. Take a bite from the right and wait and see, or tear off a chunk from the left and hope for the best. Unable to make a decision, she grabbed a piece from both sides and ate them at the same time, hoping they'd balance each other out. Luckily, they did just that, and after a while of her height rapidly changing, Alice was back to her normal self. She smiled, feeling clever that she solved the problem, and walked into the nearby forest, not knowing that she was about to discover that everyone's mad in Wonderland.
Yeah.
Annoyed by how amused the cat was by her confusion, Alice stormed off in the direction of the Mad Hatter's house. So far, she'd had no luck with animals, so she hoped a human would be better company. As she neared the house, she could hear raucous laughter, which was a good sign. The Hatter was clearly a fun guy to be around. Alice turned the corner and saw outside on the lawn a very large dining table, covered with plates, glasses and cutlery. As there were only three creatures at the table, but six or seven empty chairs, Alice decided she would sit down and have a snack at the Mad Hatter's tea party. Before she said something she'd regret, Alice marched away from the tea party, planning never to return to such an infuriating place. It wasn't long until she found herself in the palace grounds, and from the heart-shaped flowers, heart-shaped shrubbery, and the heart-shaped ornaments, Alice assumed it was the Queen of Hearts palace. It was fairly quiet in the grounds, which was a welcome relief from the absurdity of the day so far. Alice spotted someone in the far corner of the lawn, crouched over the flower bed. So she made her way over to say hello.
Counted the wrong colour bush.
Alice had never really played croquet before, but she was pretty certain the games weren't meant to end in execution. Trying not to cause a scene and be seen by the Queen, Alice quietly slipped away, not wanting to be part of a shambolic croquet game anymore. Not quite knowing what she should do next, she walked into a peaceful garden and stood for a minute to collect her thoughts. Alice was now even more baffled. People in Wonderland certainly were strange. She was wondering what to do next, when the White Rabbit appeared in front of her. He played a fanfare on his trumpet to make sure he had her attention, and then announced, Your presence is requested in court. He then marched off into the distance. Alice was appalled that there was a possibility that she was being accused of doing something wrong. So she ran after the White Rabbit, ready to argue her case.
Please.
Alice knew, deep down, that her adventure had just been a dream. But she couldn't stop thinking about how real it all felt. A wave of sadness came over her as she thought about how much she missed the caterpillar, the Cheshire Cat, the Mad Hatter, the March Hare, the Dormouse and the Duchess. Despite their weird quirks and sometimes annoying traits, Alice had had a wonderful time in Wonderland and was disappointed that it was over. She then thought for a second or two and began to smile as she realised that this wondrous place would always be there. Whenever she wanted to escape the real world for a little while, she could just close her eyes and step into Wonderland.